Hi guys, today I have a special guest, Seong-ha. He's the winner of the most recent Shake It Up competition. The winning gave him a spot to represent United States in the world final that is going to happen in Estonia in October. I asked him to give recommendations, some tips on how to prepare and win mixology classic cocktail competitions. So Seong-ha, big congratulations to you, man. I know you was really, really happy to win this competition, and it's a big honor to represent the United States in such a big final. Yeah. I wanted to ask you for some tips to give to bartenders on how you prepare for competition, on what ingredients you use, your motivation, your inspiration. So if you could share as much as possible, that would be great. I'm still dreaming about your hands, your lies.
How can I get my inspiration for the cocktail? That's easy. First thing to do your homework, researching about the brand and finding the history, background, a lot of secrets. When you found it and then when you hit the point, you can connect with your cocktail with the brand. How am I preparing my cocktail? I'm always make the recipe first, but not only one. I make the two or three different variations. Then after the different garnishes too. When I make the recipe, I'm trying to make an extra drink. Then I give to the different people. When they tasting, then they give to my feedback. Then when I got my feedback, I try to make the perfect balanced cocktail. But if I'm not happy with my recipe, of course I have to redo. Then after when I got my perfect recipe, I'm so happy with it, and I'm all ready to do my routine. My routine is simple. I'm always set up with the same tool and same bottles and the same setup. And if your house, I don't know how many surfaces you have, but I'm always set up with the same thing. Like always my spirits, all the ingredients on my left side, my tin, all the tools are in my center, and then my bar spoon is always the right side. And I'm always using extra ice because the dilution is a very important part too. And after that, you should finish when you got the 7 minutes limited, you should finish your practice 30 or 40 seconds before the time. Because who knows, when you went to the stage, you got nervous, shaking your hand, then you missing your some tins or items, then you lost your time. So you should finish before the time, 30 or 40 seconds before. And also you should reading over the rule at least 50 times. A lot of rules not perfect. They have the weakness too. You can find the weakness. I told you, be smart. Then you should using two different tools. One for the when you're familiar with your tool, and I'm always bringing my two different tools. For the competition, looking good like gold jigger, gold shaker, looking gorgeous because this is the competition. You should prepare, you should look like so much professional. So this is my final tips about the routine. Doing your practice at least 50 times till 100 times. So just you're not looking at the bottle. Just grab your bottle because this is always here. When you start practice with the liquid, just using water bottle and then for the extra the pretend the liquid inside the jigger, same amount, then using that. Because if you just thought about, oh yeah, I can use this a little bit, then after you shaking with ice, I don't know how much dilution just came out. So you should always prepare the real situation. That's the most important part. Yeah, my favorite spirits for the competition, it depends on the sponsor brand. So if the whiskey brand came out, I have to work with their brand, the Scotch whiskey or bourbon. Then if the gins came out, then I have to work with the gin. That's the rule, right? It's a sponsor brand. Then my personal favorite spirits, whiskey, gin, tequila, rum so far. My favorite non-alcoholic ingredients so far, a lot of different citrus fruits and different fruits I never use, and also a lot of greens like beets, kale, and also spinach, wheatgrass, those a lot of healthy one, because right now I'm focusing about our healthy or low alcohol drinks. That's my favorite ingredient so far. My tips on appearance for the cocktail competition, we always have to looking super sharp and professional. So first thing is a known brand, and if you're working in uniform, it's cool because you're working over there. Then if you have a shirt and your suit full set, always wearing full jacket and suit, pants, vest, tie, and if you have the bow tie, whatever, this looks like super professional bartender. Also, we need to trim our hair. If it looks like dirty, that's not good for that, because that's a part of appearance too. We should looking super professional. I always deal with the nervous. First thing is practice, always, over. Then after that, you should think about the judges are your customer, because they're the same thing. They're just judging your drinks. But you should think about, these judges are my customer. And after that, when you prepare ready to competition, just joining the competition, because that experience makes you getting better than better. My favorite competition is first thing is Bulls Around the World, because the competition changed my life. And second one is MIB competition, Most Imaginative Bartender Competition by Bombay Sapphire. But no matter what, you know, small or big, everything to change your life. Just trying, keep going, and do it again, and never give up. Thank you for having me this time. It was a great opportunity, and if you guys have any question or reach out with me, feel free to contact with my Facebook or my Instagram. I'm always wide open, so just send me a request and send me any message that I'm waiting for you guys. Thank you.